Dear Diary. What? It's me, Scryptar. Who else would be writing to you? Quit fooling around. The folks and I are trying to do a video here. Let's start over. Dear Diary. This morning I woke up pretty early. The sun wasn't even up yet. The torches cast the eerie light around the house, and all in all, it was quite nice. Yesterday I was pretty lucky. I took the pteranodon for a spin, and I actually managed to find two beavers fighting two sarcos. So I took my chances and plundered their dam. Got a pretty good amount of cementing paste right here. I also managed to craft some more narcotics. With those, I'm probably gonna tame those beavers. Well, not those, they are dead. The sun wasn't yet up, so I decided to get out of the house, have a quick look around, and then do our daily chores, which means gathering berries, getting thatch, getting wood, getting fiber, getting stones. I am sure you can understand how much it helps having a stego lady at your disposal. Long gone were the times when we actually had to gather berries by hand, and just look at how quick this goes in comparison. We got stacks of berries in no time at all. We also managed to secure some thatch, some wood, but that was not important. Since we had metal tools available now, I actually managed to build some yesterday, and I was going to use them later on to gather more thatch and more wood. For now, I continued gathering berries, and while I was doing so, I reminisced about yesterday evening. I actually managed to unlock chitin armor. That's one other thing I want to take care of today, but that's for later when the sun is up and when we have enough materials. We still need to get and find some scorpions. Those give some very good chitin in the beginning. Later on, there are other means available, but for now, that's just perfect. Since we're almost level 60, well, we're getting there, and that means Rex time. When I got back to the house, I parked our trusty stego lady right outside the door. I already had the berries transferred to myself, so I went inside and put them in the mortar and pestle stands. There were quite a few berries actually, as you can see. One of those actually still had some spoiled meat in there. So I thought to myself, well, you know, why not start it right now? Just fire it up, get it running. It's always good to have. After that, I turned towards the storage and put away our wood and our thatch. I also made sure that all the stacks are really full, so we don't have any half stacks in there or anything weird. You know, I like to have it organized. After thatch, I did the same to wood, got back outside, and I had a look in the feeding trough. There was a ton of spoiled meat in there, which is good because we needed that. 100 for one, 100 for the other, and that should give us 100 narcotics each, plus whatever we have left in the first one that we've already started. That's good. 230, 240 narcotics. Definitely an improvement. When that was done, I went back outside. The sun was rising. It was time to gather some stones, now that we could actually see them lying on the ground everywhere. It was still a little bit chilly and the torches were still lit. I'm really, really happy about that. I'm also happy about having unlocked fur armor. That would come in handy. After the stone was taken care of, I went back outside to gather wood. We still had plenty of thatch and plenty of fiber from the last day, so I didn't really bother about that, but we definitely needed more wood. I mean, look at all those gates we put up, and I actually managed to put spike walls all around the top of our base so that nothing could fall down and wreak havoc on our dinos. I also managed to put some spike walls outside of our walls, just in case, you know, it's always good to have those. Now that those tasks were out of the way, I went back inside and emptied my inventory, made sure that the wood was stacked nicely, thatch as well. Like I said, it's always good to keep it nice and organized, maximize your storage. The fiber situation was pretty much out of control. We got a lot of fiber, due to the fact that yesterday I actually managed to build a sickle. I'm carrying that around in my inventory at the moment, but I might find a place to store it. We don't need it that often. Then I took our flyer for a spin. I wanted to get those last few levels just to get to level 60 and be able to ride the Rex, so we could get some more meat and some more hide, because we definitely needed hide. Now, for our flyer, I managed to level him up quite a bit yesterday. I think I was up to about nearly 200% movement speed. So we went down to the spawn point and had a look around. I was hoping for scorpions, like I said earlier. I just wanted to get some chitin. I wanted to make that chitin armor. For the moment, I have one piece which I found in the drop. It's actually a green one, a ramshackle leggings, I think. That's definitely cool. But I want more. This is not enough. I mean, we learned this stuff for a reason, right? So I was flying around for quite a while, having a look if I find any leftover scorpions. But as the sun was already up, there was not much spawning in that area. And the spawn point was already busy with saber chews and all of that crap. We don't need that. So I went over to the snow biome. It got really cold. I'm desperately looking forward to that fur armor. But for that, first of all, we need fur. And we're not quite in a position to do that yet. So, for the moment, I'm just here to find scorpions, and that's what I did. Now, fighting scorpions is not a big deal. Not for me, anyway, if you know how to do it. It was just the old routine, as you always do on a Pteranodon. Swoop in, do a barrel roll, get out of range, do it a couple of times, rest for stamina, do it again. Or as they say, rinse and repeat. I got, well, I found a stego who got in the way. Poor stego. Kind of took off. I never really found it again when I tried looking for it to get the meat. Well, anyway, I looked around a little more, found a couple more scorpions. One was stuck in a tree. I helped him out of his misery there. When I tried to get back to that one, after a much needed rest, it was taking off with some saber tooth, having more fun than it should have. Couldn't allow that. So I got back in there. And I'm pretty sure I killed them both. It's a pity really, but what can you do? Anyway, once that was done, I flew up the mountain beside my base. Had a look if there was any more to be had. What a surprise, I actually found a blue drop right there and a couple more scorpions. When I had a look at the drop, it wasn't really what I had expected from a blue drop, but it was definitely better than nothing. We got a fresh blueprint. It was a metal door. I like metal blueprints. Metal is the last tier. If you get the blueprint, you don't have to learn it. They are not a requirement for anything else because they are the last tier. If you don't learn a wooden wall and you get a blueprint for that, well, if you want to have a stone wall, you need to have learned the wooden wall. It doesn't really help. For metal, it's great. So when that was done, killed a couple more scorpions, got really tight there for a moment. They hit us a couple of times, so top off the Pteranodon was going up quite high. It didn't pass out, we managed. We killed them all. It's what we do, it's part of our daily tasks. When that was done, we got back home. And while flying back home and looking at our base from above, I actually thought, this really could look a little bit better. There's still much work to do. I mean, those spike walls sure look nice and they do the trick. But that's not all there is to it. We need a safe place for our flyers. We can still be attacked from the air. So while incoming, having a good look at our base, I decided that we need to get started on the aviary. That is definitely a project to be had for today. But then again, this whole scorpion killing not only provided us with some chitin, it also gave us the last level we needed to finally be level 60, and that meant Rex time. Being back safe inside the walls of our house, I quickly learned the engram for the Rex saddle. It was to be crafted in the smithy. How good that we actually managed to do that smithy last episode and that we got this far with the house. There it was, it only took hide, fiber and a little bit of metal. I already had the metal in there since I went out yesterday and got some which I smelted up. So I quickly went over to our freshly sorted storage, got the hide, got the fiber, transferred it over to the smithy and got started on the saddle. Well, on the second try at least. I didn't manage to get enough hide and I wasn't even sure where I had it, so it took me a while longer than expected, but that happens in the best of families, right? When the crafting was done, I quickly went outside. Lady Rex was already standing there, eagerly awaiting her saddle. So I slapped it on, mounted Lady Rex, and she was really... happy to see me. Obviously. So we started doing what we wanted to do since we got her. We started wrecking faces. First animal to die was a Saku. It was really just lying in the sun, having fun, doing nothing in particular, but it was on our way. Then we started emptying the pond of all fish there was. At this early development of the Rex, being like leveled up 3 or 4 times, we could get levels by killing fish, and that's what we did. And we got a lot of meat from that, and another level. Then we went around the shore and pretty much killed everything we could find. Doesn't matter if it was a Sabertooth, a Kano, an Argentavis. It really didn't matter. We just killed everything. It took a while, but we definitely made more progress than anything else on this island ever had up to this day. And we got quite a good amount of levels out of it. After about 7 or 8 levels, we went back home. The amount of meat we had was unreal. We dropped it on the floor mostly because there was just nothing we could have done with it. However, the chitin situation was different. There were only 2 scorpions and we only got the teeniest amount of it. Hide we got a fair good amount, about 5 or 6 stacks, and that is what we really wanted. We needed hide for the future, we needed more spiked walls and stuff like that. So after coming back home, we quickly sorted our inventory, dropped all this stuff into the boxes, and called it a day in terms of fighting and gathering. Now it's out for building. First thing I wanted to do is get the chitin armor done, so I quickly grabbed the stack, went over to the smithy, threw it in there, and queued every piece up. Well, except for the pants, we already had those, and we had them on Ramshackle, so why bother? I had a look at fur as well, but we need a lot more materials and a lot more advanced materials for that, so currently we're doing fine with chitin. I also had a look at the fabricator, and that was really something I wanted to do next. So as soon as the armor was done, I put it on, stashed away the old hide armor just in case you might ever need it again, went outside because it started raining, and I thought, well, free drink is free drink, why not grab it? I needed it anyway. Then I went back to the smithy and had a look. What did we actually need? We should have had all the materials available to us, except for the oil. Crystal was there, I grabbed some from our 2 with the Rex, since we had a metal pick now. But the oil was definitely something we needed to go and get, so I quickly jumped up on our Pteranodon, flew down, and just grabbed some. That's what we're here for, right? That's why we choose this as a base location. The rocks are just outside the door. We already cleared the area, there was not much going on here. So a few well-aimed hits with the pick, and we had more than enough oil. Well, maybe a few more hits. And now we had the last piece of the puzzle. We could finally start making that fabricator. Didn't really take that long. See? I was really excited. Finally, 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 we could plug the last hole in our house. That big eyesore of an empty space. So I grabbed the fabricator, lined it up with the edge of, well, the floor ceilings. You know, OCD. It needs to be perfect. Got into K mode, crouched down so I was able to place it, and after a little wiggling around, I was able to line it up quite nicely. See? Looks good. Little more wiggling maybe. Oh well. Perfect spacing. Committed. Bang. There you go. Fabricator done. So we now could start to get into some serious building. It was time to start the aviary. For the landing platform we needed some ceilings and those needed supports, so I decided to show off the pillar trick. Which means, if you do not want to show the nubs of the pillar showing through the bottom, through the ceiling, you could place a pillar in the middle of the ceiling. Like that. Then you could snap a pillar to the bottom by moving down a little bit further. You could actually manage to not snap it to the ceiling, showing those nubs, but to the pillar that's already placed. Once that done and it connected to the ground, you could remove the intermediary pillar. See? No nubs. That's pretty much all we needed. Now we had a landing platform 2x3. We definitely needed a gate now. Now the gate is 2x4, 2 wide, 4 high. So I started placing some walls, 4 high on either side of the gate. We already had a doorway there, so it's only 3 walls on one side, 4 on the other. Then I lined myself up so I was standing perfectly in the middle of those ceilings we just placed, so I was in the middle of the whole structure. Then I used what I thought to be my pick, but since I'd exchanged that with a metal pick, I needed something else. I used the crossbow to get the crosshair, and I lined that up with the middle of the ceiling at the end of my vision. I then got into K mode, got out the gate, and started placing. The usual happened. I needed to look down a little, so I got out of K mode, used the arrow keys to look down, and when I finally had the gate where I wanted it to be, you know, the usual, a little wiggling around, it was perfectly centered. I just couldn't decide if I wanted to have it sticking out or sticking inward. When I finally managed to find a real good space where I wanted it, I placed it. Done deal. Looked perfect. Say? As you can tell, the gate is technically the wrong way around, but I wanted the doors to open inward, so I had to place the gate this way. Works perfectly. Now off to the next step. We needed walls around the building. I decided to go with wooden fences here for a number of reasons. First of all, you can look through them and you have quite a nice view. It's better than having those walls really fencing you in. Huh, no pun intended, of course. Then again, this shows off one of the peculiarities of ARK when it comes to building. Remember that we had placed four walls on top of each other. Now these fences, they are not exactly half a wall high, so you can actually put 9 instead of 8 on top of each other, and it will line up perfectly with the top of that fourth wall. However, that gives you some trouble when you try to place ceilings. If you place the fence first, everything is fine, but if you actually manage to place the ceiling first and then want to fill up your stack of fences or railings, you can't place the last one. You will see that here in a moment, when this building is actually finished and we put on the ceilings. On the spot on top right there, I actually placed 9, and as you can see, that fits. Now, for all the others, I just used 8, and you can see that there's a space. This little space won't really hurt anyone. Nothing can get through there, maybe a dimorphodon. But as you can see, we can't place another rail up there. So, for this particular building, I guess it just has to stay the way it is. Now, having the walls 4 high, you can place ceilings just by jumping a little bit. They will snap, it's no problem at all. Build one wall higher and it wouldn't work. If the height of the gate is not enough reason to actually have a building this high, that's all the reason you need. Come on. And done. That's our aviary. And last but not least, it was now time to get working on a gate. We needed a stone behemoth gate for that. I learned the required engrams and all the prerequisites, went over to the smithy, and there it was. Quite expensive. 450 stone, wood and thatch, but we had all that from our gathering earlier. Say, no issue. Another little trick I used here, because 500 stone is actually too much to carry, I looked up a little bit and chucked them out of my inventory so I could move again. They landed over at the smithy, so I picked them up right there and I moved them over. Works every time. Naturally, I had to do the same with wood. As long as you don't forget to pick it back up, use the timer, that's what it's there for. Items stay on the ground for a while. Here it's about 6 minutes, so we have all the time in the world. You can even do the same with building materials if you can't carry them. Just drop them on the floor, just don't forget to pick them back up. For thatch, obviously that wasn't necessary. It doesn't weigh that much in comparison. And there we go, that's our gate. Took no time at all to craft. And we're off to put it down. Now for actually selecting the right spot, it's fairly easy. There's only one way up here, right? I mentioned that earlier. So what I had to find out is where was the part where I couldn't get up, right at the border, right there. Once I had that, it was pretty easy to determine where the gate would go. Now this gate is 7 foundations wide. The way it snaps, you would actually need 8 if you wanted it to snap somewhere. There's no need here. We didn't really need a wall or anything else. We just wanted to make sure that nothing can go up the only path that we have. It needed some fiddling around, some tweaking to get it in the right position, and to make sure that it didn't hover off the ground with the left pillar. There you can see that. But finally I found a really good position where I wanted to have it and place it right there. Don't call me a liar. Right there. Thank you. There's our gate. Quickly had a look, and as you can see, there is not really much room to crawl underneath. Nothing can get through there. So the only thing that can now be of any danger to us are flyers. Well, first of all, of course, we actually needed the gate. We only had the gateway. So for the gate, same amount of materials. It's quite expensive if you think about it. For one gate plus door, it's 900 stone, 900 wood, 900 thatch. If you want to build a wall out of this, that's quite expensive. But then again, 7 wide and I think it's 11 high. Try building that in actual stone walls, which cost 80 stone each. Those gates are cheaper in the long run. And there we go. That's our door crafting up right there. Takes about as much time as the gate itself. So if you have enough materials, you can actually queue that up and have 5 or 6 crafted one after the other and do something else in the meantime. Bam, door. This would really look nice with a little bit of paint, but as this is a starter base, we're not gonna bother. Eventually we will tear it all down. Then again, we might not. We might just turn this into a museum or something like that. You'll never know. And there you have it. The base in all its glory. The torches are lit. Sun is setting down. Have another quick look at the gate. That really doesn't look too bad, right? Yeah, it looks fine. That's what we wanted. In the meantime, I managed to place some torches around the aviary just to make it look nice. I mean, if we're coming in by flyer, we want to have a landing pad, right? We need torches. So there you are. That's what we've done today. And now, it's finally time, after a last look at our beautiful home, to turn in, close the door behind us, go to bed, wake up tomorrow morning, and then it's time to start work on the first materials for our real base. That's it for today, folks. If you like the video, subscribe for more, leave a comment if you feel like it. Don't forget to enjoy yourself. See you soon!